welcome back to my channel. Today it's Jay Canada, and I am super excited today to be bringing you all another video and the first episode of a brand new series. Now, this won't exactly be a structured series like Spin to Win or No Money Spent on my channel here. It's a squad builder series that maybe I'll upload once a week if you guys show some love on this first episode, but it's the perfect blend of playing my team on 2K20 while also looking at some NBA history, giving my opinions on it. It's all good stuff, man. I love it. As you can see from the title, today is the very first episode of our NBA Redraft Squad Builder series. That was kind of a mouthful, but you get it. Now, if you're not familiar with what a redraft is, well, it's pretty simple. I'm going to be looking at an NBA draft, for example, the 2011 draft today, and I'm going to give my opinion on what I think the order of the draft actually should have been, how it should have played out that night. Now, there's a lot of different factors to assess when redrafting. For me, I like to weigh a player's resume, like what we've seen them do already, with what I think they could still bring forward in the current day, because of course, these players from the 2011 draft are mostly all still playing in the league. Either way you slice it, I know a ton of you guys are gonna yell at me for my opinions in the comment section, and honestly, I love it. I'd love to see your guys' list of what you think the 2011 draft should have looked like down below. Let me know who I screwed up on. In each of these videos, we'll look at how the draft actually played out, the order, and we'll laugh at some picks because some are really bad. And then I'll redraft the order I think is right. We'll put together the squad in 2K, and we'll go play a game of my team. I've decided randomly today to start with the 2011 draft because, well, it's super loaded, as you'll see, and also really crazy. Like, the order, it's just, what were people thinking? But please let me know in the comments section which draft you'd like to see. There's so many good ones that we can cover. We'll do them in a random order, so yeah, if you drop me a comment, I might just make it happen. And the final thing I wanted to mention before we get into it, I know it's a lot. I was inspired to make this type of video, this series, thanks to the Book of Basketball podcast on The Ringer. It's a Bill Simmons podcast where him and others have been redrafting drafts. I love that podcast. I found them so interesting, so I figured I should bring it in video form in my own way. But go check out the Book of Basketball pod if you also want to hear that, because it's pretty good stuff. Now let's get into the 2011 redraft squad builder. Let's go. Now, like I said, first things first, let's look at the 2011 NBA draft results just to jog your guys' memory on who was in this draft. Now, picked first overall, not a bad pick, Kyrie Irving to the Cavaliers, but immediately after that, things went south. Derek Williams to the Timberwolves, Enes Kanter, Tristan Thompson, Jonas Valanciunas. At least you got some NBA players in there, but Jan Vesely, that's a tough one. Bismack Biyombo, not great. Brandon Knight is okay. Kemba Walker, definitely a stud. My guy, Jimmer Fredette, pick number 10. I wish that one worked out. But as we get into the middle of the round, you'll see guys like Klay Thompson pop up, the Morris twins, Kawhi Leonard, of course. Down towards the end of the first round, we see Nikola Mirotic, Reggie Jackson, some pretty good options. Also, Jimmy Butler. Into the second round, there's even some good picks. Bojan Bogdanovic, Chandler Parsons was okay. Davis Bertans? Yeah, he was picked in 2011. I was surprised. Even to the final pick in the draft, 60th overall, Isaiah Thomas. So basically, boys, yeah, this draft is going to get wild. Now, I briefly explained how I'm redrafting, how I'm choosing to view this draft. I'm weighing what guys have done in the NBA already, and because of most of these players are all, well, actually all of these players are still playing, I'm deciding to look at like what I think these players can do going forward. So that's how I determine the order of this draft. I'll explain each pick, but yeah, why don't we get into it? With the first overall selection in the 2011 redraft, I am sending Kawhi Leonard to the Cleveland Cavaliers. Kawhi originally went 15th to the Indiana Pacers. He was then traded to the Spurs. He put up pretty good numbers at San Diego State, but people obviously didn't think he had the offensive capabilities that he ended up having. But for me, Kawhi's got the best resume of anybody in the draft. I mean, 2 championships, 2 finals MVP, 2 defensive player of the years, individual numbers, like he's still catching up with like the points and assists, but clearly Kawhi is going to end up being an all-time great in the NBA. This one, kind of a no-brainer. With the second pick in the 2011 redraft, I'm going Kyrie Irving to the Minnesota Timberwolves. Now, Kyrie originally went number 1, so pretty, you know, not really a fall for him to go to number 2. He only played like 9 games at Duke, remember? Like, it was crazy. I don't know if you guys are going to disagree with me at Kyrie at number 2, but even though he's a bit of a, I don't know, he's a bit of a nutcase these days, I'm not sure if I would really want to have him on my team now. He's got a really solid resume. Rookie of the Year, 2 times All-NBA, and of course, the 2016 NBA Finals, which he was fantastic, hit the game-winning shot. I think Kyrie going forward and what he's already accomplished is the second best player in the draft. draft. We move on to number three, where things get a little bit interesting. Maybe you think this guy should have gone already, but I'm saying Klay Thompson to the Utah Jazz. Klay was picked 11 by Golden State, which is just a fantastic pick by them, and a big miss by a number of others, out of Washington State. I think some people probably would have put Klay ahead of Kyrie, because of course, Klay has three rings, but to me, he's just not like a number one option on a team. He's like maybe the best second option we've ever seen, arguably the greatest spot up shooter, but we haven't been able to see him carry a team yet, and I don't think we ever will, so that's why I have him ranked number third in this draft. Number three in this draft, that makes more sense.
You're stupid.
We move on to number four and another potentially controversial pick. This is where I'm saying Kemba Walker, drafted by Cleveland. Now, Kemba originally went ninth to Charlotte, and kind of a tough way for him to start his career. Of course, now he's in Boston, which is much better for him. For me, Kemba Walker has become a really dependable, you know, 23.6 assists per game guy, made one All-NBA team, and by all accounts, he's a really good leader and teammate, which is why I would want Kemba Walker on my team, which is what moves him up a little bit in the rankings. His resume isn't great, but that's also partially because he was on a pretty bad team for the first chunk of his career. And just so we're all keeping track, I'm sorry, Cleveland, but you could have had Kawhi Leonard and Kemba Walker. So that would have been pretty good. We move on to the fifth overall pick, this one going to Toronto, and for me, I'm taking Jimmy Butler. Jimmy Butler went way too low at 30 in the real draft, and I bet some of you are saying he went too low in this one. It was a pretty tough call, honestly. Jimmy was actually tough to slot behind Kemba because he's had a better resume, 2 times All-NBA, 4 times All-Defense. But for me, Jimmy Butler has been traded 3 times in his career already, and that's because he's notably a tough teammate, and I don't know, moving forward, I'm not sure if I think Jimmy Butler's more valuable than Kemba, but hey, you can flame me for this pick. That's just the way I looked at things. At number 6, the Washington Wizards were picking. They took Jan Vesely. That's the wrong European big man. I'm giving them Nikola Vucevic instead. Vucevic. That's the one name I can never say. I'm sorry. Nikola went 16th overall to Philadelphia. I think he was traded immediately. I can't exactly remember, out of USC. Vucevic is a walking double-double. Ever since he entered the league, it's that simple. He's never really done anything in the playoffs, but peaking at about 20 points per game, he can lead the offense as a big man. Just, yeah, a really solid player. Another really solid player coming in at number 7th on my draft big board, Tobias Harris to the Sacramento Kings. Tobias was originally drafted by the Milwaukee Bucks, one of like 17 different teams he's been on. Harris has a pretty sparse resume, to be honest, but he's become a really dependable 19.7 rebound per game guy in the past 3 seasons, and he's also succeeded in a bunch of different situations. I like his versatility, to be honest. Coming in at number 8 to the Detroit Pistons, I kind of wanted to slot this dude higher, but I think 8 is a good spot for Bojan Bogdanović. Bojan was originally the first pick in the 2nd round, and he's been really surprisingly productive throughout his career. He doesn't have any All-NBA teams or anything like that on his resume, but he's a perfect player to randomly dominate games in 2020. Like we saw for Indiana in the playoffs a couple years ago against LeBron and the Cavs, he was really, really good because he's such a good 3-point shooter. I think he could be a really good 2nd or 3rd option on an NBA championship team. For my 9th and 10th pick in this draft, I have 2 big men. They were really hard for me to decide which order to put them in, so let's see if you guys agree with me. At number 9, I'm saying Jonas Valanciunas to the Charlotte Hornets. Jonas was really touted coming in for the Raptors and never quite lived up to the hype. But I will say, you know, he's probably not that suited for the 2020 game because he doesn't shoot the 3 all that well, but he's produced really solid numbers throughout his career and he's been consistent. So 9th seems like a good spot for him. And the other big man I was talking about coming in at number 10 to Milwaukee, Tristan Thompson. Now, originally Tristan went 1 spot ahead of Jonas, so I had a tough time, you know, deciding which one to put where. But Tristan's been pretty much a walking double-double, not much depth to his game. He's not that versatile offensively, but he's shown what he can do at the highest level. I'll never forget the 2016 finals when he was really valuable to the Cavaliers. So that contribution to the finals makes me rank him higher than maybe some of you, but I just value playoff performance so highly. And at pick number 11 to the Golden State Warriors, I'm sending Isaiah Thomas. Isaiah Thomas, of course, originally the last player in the draft, a great pick by the Sacramento Kings. I know some of you were probably yelling at me to take Isaiah higher, but in all honesty, he had 2 really, really good seasons, and that's why why he ranks 11th on my draft board. If Boston had another star alongside Isaiah in those 2 years, they could have gone to the finals quite possibly, but the fact that Thomas's career has really fizzled at this point, that puts him down on my draft board. At number 12 to the Utah Jazz, I am sending Marcus Morris. He was originally actually the second Morris twin drafted, but I think we can all agree he's had a little bit better of a career. Morris, to me, is the definition of a really good role player. Like, he can score, he can defend. It's nothing amazing, but he's really good and he's not scared of the big moments. And our final draft slot today coming in at number 13, because that's the max we can do for our 2K lineup. To the Phoenix Suns, I am sending Davis Bertans. Now, Bertans originally went 42nd overall to the, he went to the Spurs and then he was traded. Was he a part of the Kawhi trade? I should know this, but I don't.
Yes.
Now, Bertans hasn't done much in his career so far, but I'm picking him because I think what he will become in the next few years is super valuable. He's averaging 15 points a game on over 40% shooting this year when the season got suspended, and having a big man with his size and his shooting ability in 2020, man, that's freaking valuable. But there you have it, guys, the 13 picks of the 2011 redraft. Let me know again what you guys think. Some of these were really hard decisions, and I'm willing to admit that I may have been wrong. Here's a look at it if you want to see it one more time in order, in the order I put them in. This was really fun to do, and I think it's going to be a fun team to use in 2K. And by the way, shout out to the honorable mention. These are some of the guys who possibly could have been in there. Reggie Jackson, Markieff Morris, Enes Kanter, Iman Shumpert, Brandon Knight. There you have it. That is the 2011 redraft. Now let's go see how this team looks in 2K. This 2011 draft was low-key loaded. I mean, look at all these dudes. Kawhi, Klay, Kyrie. Obviously, in 2K, it's a nice team, but also looking at the order of the draft, like, probably one of the most stacked drafts in recent memory, so I'm really curious to hear what you guys thought about the players I chose. I'm also really curious to see if I can't go take a W, so let's get it going.
Oh! He needs some milk!
Am I really playing a dude with Opal LeBron, Opal Thon Maker, Opal Dwight? Why do I keep getting these matchups, bro? If this dude's trash at the game, I might actually win. If he's good at the game even a little bit, I'm gonna take a big L. So, yeah, this should be fun. Oh, he's running a zone. Okay, so yeah, he might be trash. Cool. That was a terrible shot. My word. Yep. Okay, well, just stay in that zone and I'll shoot wide open jumpers all game. I'm good with it, sir. Oh my... I baited that dude so hard for that pass, I was ahead of it, and I couldn't steal it because I knew what he was doing even before he did. That's so funny. This dude is really not good at the game, but his team is so good, he might just beat me. Come on, Klay. Oh my goodness. Wow, I made that. That was a horrible release. Oh, that was a good release. Okay, so he can shoot with LeBron. Fair enough. Best card in the game, whatever. Ugh, Tobias Harris has a horrible jump shot. I mean, he made it, so I can't be that mad, but that is ugly. Oh, I should have had that steal and that block. Come on, Kawhi. Oh, Tobias. It's an ugly jumper, but I'm greening it. This is going to be the most repetitive gameplay I think I've ever posted. Like, it's just going to be me shooting threes. That's it. I'm warning you right now. Oh, Nikola Vucevic. Look at that steal. What a stud. What a stud. Look at Kyrie's ball fake. Wow, I really bricked that after an elite ball fake. Seriously. I don't even know. Oh, it's subbed in Jonas Valanciunas. I guess fair enough. I need the most shooting I can have out here. So no Tristan Thompson, please. That would be the move. Oh, what? Why are you fouling, Jimmy? Just play defense, bro. Boyan in the corner. That's beautiful. I'll do that all game. Good D, Marcus Morris. Yeah, perfect role player. That's what I called him. And it's true. Boyan, speaking of perfect releases. Oh yeah, that worked out perfectly. More good defense. More. I'm not jumping at you. Jonas is there, bro. Jonas is there. He's happy I ranked him ahead of Tristan Thompson. Yes, okay. One step over this way. Boyan. Freaking missing a shot. Gosh darn it, Jason. This man's really bought some of the most expensive collections in this game just to sit in a horrible 2-3 zone, which I can't beat because I am bricking shots. Like, this whole video is just very, very tragic. I'm not even gonna lie. Marcus Morris wide open, and I bricked it. Of course. You just bail him out with free throws. Oh, this game is annoying me because this should not be a contest. Even with his team like this, he's not good. So hopefully in the third quarter, I can go on a run when I'm just like, I'm going to focus on being great because I'm not being great right now. And that is a problem. Jimmy Butler. Oh, I got to green that. Well, I got bailed out anyways. Hopefully I can do better here in the third.
A few moments later.
All right, fellas, fourth quarter, I was able to extend my lead a bit. I'm up 5. I don't know why I can't pull away in this game. Actually, I do. I'm just not shooting well. That's it. He's sitting in the zone and I am not able to make him pay for it, but it's all good. We're going to win this game. I have no doubts. Jimmy buckets. Nope, nope, nope. Look at this dude. He can't even be in the passing lane. Like, he is not good. And yet I might let him win this game. That is embarrassing for me. Oh my goodness, this is really a three-point game. I'm mad at myself that this is a three-point game right now. Like, this is crazy. Come on, man. Come on. Come on, starters. I can't joke this. 2011 draft. We're loaded, playing a trash opponent. All I have to do is hit this wide open shot. Right there. That's it. Okay, give me more of those, please. Oh, good block. Vucevic. Yes, yes. What? They let him get the rebound? Come on, man. We are getting stops out here. Kyrie bump? Nope, nope, nope. Oh, my word. Come on, Kyrie in the clutch. Kyrie. I've lost the ability to hit greens with my boy Kyrie, but at least he did make the shot. Never mind. Never mind. In the clutch. That's why Kyrie stayed at number 2 in my redraft. The boy's clutch. Like, what do you want me to say? That was a huge shot right there. There it is. Kawhi with the dagger in the corner. I don't know how this dude keeps getting back in the game, but I promise that was a steal. No way. No way. No. Game over. I don't even care. Get the rebound. This game's over. This wasn't a game I should have had to sweat through in like a million years, but I did, and I got the win. That's what's important. Our team was led by Klay Thompson, rightfully so. He moved up in my draft rankings. Kyrie was cool. Boyan off the bench, I knew I had to include him. Kawhi did hit the eventual dagger. Yeah, that was a really fun team to use. It was just a bit of a frustrating game. But the inaugural episode of our NBA redraft squad builder series, let me know if you guys enjoyed. If you don't, maybe this will be the only one, but you can also let me know other drafts you'd like to see, what you thought the order should have been, and more. I appreciate everyone who watched this video and shows some love down below, so I'll see you in the next one. Peace.